Action.
This video is going to show you how to take your file after you've created it in Fusion and get it ready to use on the laser cutter, on the laser cutter computer itself. First thing, if the program's not already open, it's this green one on the bottom of the screen here. It's called CorelDRAW. CorelDRAW is only on this computer. It's a little bit tricky to use, and it's not something I'm an expert at, but I do know how to do a few things. So first, create a new document. Do not open your document, but create a new document. And it'll automatically bring up something that's the size of the laser cutter printer, laser cutter bed, 29 by 17. Then plug in your flash drive and do not click on your file in here. Close this window that automatically opens when you plug in your flash drive. Then go to File, Import, or Control I. Once you're in this folder, you need to find your flash drive. It's usually at the bottom over here. This one's called Kingston, and I made something called Example Letter. So I'm going to import this. And in this screen, you usually don't need to change anything unless your units are wrong. And you can, it also previews the size that it's gonna show up at in inches here. I'm gonna click OK. And then I'm gonna place it near the top left corner of the work screen. At this point, it comes up highlighted. You can click out to unhighlight it. There might be something you want to delete, like the outside border. So I'm going to click on just that border and use actually delete on the keyboard, not backspace. If you want to scale it, you can scale it up here using the percentages. It'll tell you its size up here in inches. You can also rotate it as well. You can click on the center to rotate as well, but it's better to use these windows here if you want to rotate it. And I want to rotate this 90 degrees, and that looks a little bit better right there. To make something cut on the laser cutter, it needs to be red, and to make something engrave, it needs to be black. So most of the time we're going to be using red. I'm going to highlight my letter, and then down here at the bottom of the screen in this corner is the stroke button. There's fill and stroke. You're going to double click on the stroke one right here. This will pull up this window here. And we're going to change our color. It needs to be an RGB, and it needs to be 255 for red and 0 and 0 for green and blue. You want the width to be hairline, and that's usually all that matters in this window. So now I can see I've got these red lines here that I can cut out. That may be all that you need to do. Then at that point, you can go to Control P for print, or File, Print. In this window, if you want to change some of the preferences on the laser cutter, you can go into Preferences, which you don't usually need to do, so I won't show it in this video. But if you're using a different material or engraving in a certain way, you'll need to go into Preferences. You do often need to go into Layout, and make sure in the Layout tab, it says Center of Page, top left corner. It needs to say top left corner instead of center of page right here. Then hit print. It's been sent to the print driver now, and it can run on the computer. It's pretty hard to find that though. Way down here in this corner of the screen, you can click the up arrow, this little arrow here. I wish this were easier. And then this is really weird too. You can sometimes double click on this, and sometimes you need to right click on it and then click on the top bar back here, but usually you can just double click on it and it will open this window here. This is my file ready to print, and if the laser cutter was on right now, I could just hit start. In a separate video, I'll show you how to power up the laser cutter and zero the bed. All right, thanks.